हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ केमिकल प्रोसेस डिजाइन एंड सिमुलेशंस कोर्स कोड CHE446। एंड एज यू नो देर आर फोर सीओलोज ऑफ दिस कोर्स। सीओलो नंबर वन इज रिलेटेड टू फंडामेंटल्स, नंबर टू इज रिलेटेड टू सिमुलेशन, नंबर थ्री एनालिसिस, एंड नंबर फोर डिजाइन। सो इन दिस लेक्चर, विच इज लेक्चर नंबर 27, वी विल डू द हीट एक्सचेंजर नेटवर्क डिजाइन। एंड दिस लेक्चर इज बेस्ड ऑन लेक्चर नंबर 24, 25, 26, विच वी हैव discussed earlier. In the previous lectures, we have calculated the heat utility requirements, the cooling utility requirements, the pinch temperatures, the hot pinch temperature, and the cold pinch temperature. And we have developed the grand composite curve, the shifted composite curve, and we have used the Excel sheet to verify these. And we will discuss the stream splitting rule over here as well. So, for the heat exchanger network design, how we represent the network grid? First, we need to arrange the streams in such a way that hot streams are placed first and cold streams are placed below. Just like this. This is a four stream example in which two streams are hot, two streams are cold. First, you need to arrange the hot streams like this. Number two stream, the initial temperature 170 degree centigrade, the target temperature or final temperature 60 degree centigrade, 150 to 30 degree centigrade, and the arrow should be from 170 to 60 degree centigrade, and it's quite obvious, and with the CP value 3, and for this the CP value is 1.5. then the cold streams 20 degree centigrade to 135 degree centigrade and 80 degree centigrade to 140 degree centigrade. We have already done this example with respect to calculations of utilities and pinch temperature, but we will be doing heat exchange network design for this activity as well. So what it has been written, the streams are drawn as horizontal lines with high temperatures on the left and hot streams at the top. Heat exchange matches are represented by two circles joined by a vertical line. How we do the mapping or the matching, we will see it. The grid is much easier to draw than a flow sheet, especially as heat exchanger can be placed in any order without redrawing the stream system. Means once we have drawn these streams, it's okay now. In case of flow sheet, that will be a bit difficult, and in case of grid, it is quite easy. But how, we will see it when we will go to the much complex systems. Stream splitting rule. Now, in the previous case, I had told you that usually we divide the system into two parts, at above pinch and below pinch. Now, there are certain rules for the heat exchanger networking or to place matches for above pinch and below pinch. How? And what are these rules? First thing, you need to check that above pinch, this is strictly for above pinch, that the number of hot streams should be less than or equal to number of cold streams. For example, at above pinch, you have two hot streams. So there must be a minimum of two cold streams. And if you have two cold streams and two hot streams, means these are equal, then you can go to this point for checking the CP. But if this rule is violated, you have to meet this rule. How? Then you need to divide or split a cold stream, because otherwise your design will not be okay. So once you divide the cold stream, for example, you have two hot streams and one cold stream. When you divide a cold stream, it will become two cold streams. So now this rule is not violated. It is okay. Once after checking this rule and making sure that this rule is not violated and is met, you have to go to this CP. That CP of hot stream should be less than or equal to CP of cold stream. For example, if I take you back, this is CP of hot stream, which is 3. This is CP of cold stream, which is 2. This is CP of cold stream, which is 4. Now, this 3 cannot be directly mapped with 2. Like this hot stream 2 cannot be mapped with 1 or cannot be placed matches with 1, because the CP of hot stream is higher than CP of cold stream. However, this 3 can be mapped with or matched with 4. Similarly, this 1.5 can be matched with 2 and 4, because CP of hot stream is less than CP of cold stream in both these cases. It means if you want to match 2 with 1, you need to split this hot stream. And once you split this hot stream, like if CP of H is less than equal to CP of C for every match of pinch, yes, place matches. If no, split the stream usually hot, because you want to decrease the CP, and once you split it, the CP will be divided. So once you split this stream, then it will become 1.5, 1.5. Now you can connect with these two, or it can become 2 and 1, and even you can connect with these two. But then you have to go back to this point to check that this rule is not violated. For example, you have two hot streams and three cold streams. This rule is okay. Come to here point, then you check the CP values. If CP of H is higher than CP of C, divide this hot stream. Once you divide the hot stream, the number of hot streams will be 3, the number of cold streams will be 3. It's okay, you can proceed with it. Similarly, for below pinch, the rule is opposite, that number of hot streams should be greater than or equal to number of cold streams. If this rule is okay, go to CP. If not okay, split a hot stream. In that case, we had splitted the cold stream. In this case, we have to split the hot stream to make it equal to or greater than the number of cold stream. And again, CP of H should be greater than or equal to CP of C. If yes, place matches. If no, split a hot cold stream. Like for below pinch, this 3 can be matched with 2. This 1.5 cannot be matched with any of these. How? CP of H should be greater than or equal to cold stream CP. Like 3 is greater than 2, obviously you can match 2 and 1 below pinch. But you cannot match 2 and 3 directly because CP of H is less than CP of C. So what you need to do? You need to divide this cold stream to make it 2-2. Similarly, this 1.5 cannot be matched with these two. So that is where we have to implement the rule and we have to divide the stream. But again, we need to check that whether the first rule is met or not. If not met, then you have to do this splitting like this. So that's the overall procedure of stream splitting. But obviously, we will just check this procedure today. In our next lecture, we will split, or we will go to the split part. In today's lecture, we are not going to follow any splitting part. But this rule, we will check this rule for this point. Now, choosing the value of delta t minimum, that is very, very important point. Because if you remember, in our previous lecture, we had discussed that by increasing the value of delta T minimum, which is usually your energy target, the value of heating utility, the cooling utility increases and the area decreases. But you cannot rely on these parameters. You have to check the utility, area, total area and total cost. Now, if you see this one, the hot utility, you can see with increasing delta T minimum, this value is increasing linearly. Heat exchanger area, as you can see, the heat exchanger area is decreasing. Okay, that's fine, understandable. Total area, almost the same trend as that of heat exchanger area, understand. But the total cost, as you can see, it is decreasing. To this point, it started increasing. So it means this is your region, this point region is the most suitable region for you to get the optimum value. Like in this, you have to select this value. Now, if you select delta T minimum as 0, you can see the area requirement is too high and similarly cost requirement is too high. But once you decrease it, the cost started decreasing, the area started decreasing, however with the expense of increasing utility. And in this region you can see cost is minimum with respect to all points, but after this point it started increasing. So you can say that 10 to 20 degree centigrade is the point of delta T minimum which needs to be chosen for an efficient design of heat exchanger network. And you can see at a delta T minimum of nearly 130, the cost is almost similar as that of delta T minimum of 0. So you cannot just like increase delta T minimum and decrease the area, but it is linked with increasing utilities, as you can see. So once these costs added up, the overall cost increases. So we can conclude that 10 to 20 degree centigrade is that point where there is an optimum heat exchanger network design which can be obtained here. So this diagram is very, very important regarding the heat exchanger designing and selection of the value of delta T minimum. Now, summary for heat exchanger network design, what we need to do, what steps we need to take. First, we need to divide the problem at pinch and designing each part separately. As told you in the previous lecture that once we have seen the grand composite curve, that the problem is divided at pinch, the above pinch and below pinch. And we had studied the three golden rules that we cannot transfer the heat across the pinch. We cannot use cooling utility above pinch system. We cannot use heating utility in below pinch system. These are the three golden rules. We have to meet these. Start the design at pinch and moving away. And then we have to meet these criteria of number of hot stream and CP of hot and cold stream, maximizing exchanger load, supplying external utility or external heating only above the pinch and external cooling only below the pinch. That we have already discussed it. And we have to maximize the what it means by exchanger load, that we have to reduce the utility requirement and we have to try to recover as much heat as possible by process to process interaction and by reducing the external utility load. Now, this example we have discussed in our lecture number 24, and you can see the cold stream, inlet temperature 20 degrees centigrade, outlet temperature 200, shifted temperature 30, outlet shifted temperature 210, heat load 180, CP 1. And for hot stream 150 to 50, these are the shifted temperatures and this is the heat load and CP value. And this calculation we have already done it, but for a complete heat exchange network design, you need to perform first these calculations and then do the heat exchange design. Just dividing into different lectures doesn't mean that you are always given this information in your paper or in your quiz assignment. No, that is not the case. You have been, or you will be given this table of initial, final heat load and CP, and then you have to calculate the shifted temperatures. If you want to use the problem table approach, then you have to calculate the pinch temperatures, the utilities, or if you are using a graphical approach, then again you have to calculate these values. And then you have to come to the point. Now, if you remember the first slide, we had said that hot streams are placed first on a horizontal line and cold streams are placed below. So hot stream, which is the number 2 stream, is from 150 degrees centigrade to 50 degrees centigrade, and cold stream is from 20 to 200 degrees centigrade. The hot pinch temperature is 150 degrees centigrade and cold pinch temperature is 130 degrees centigrade. Now, we have to meet all these rules, and in the end the utilities requirement should come same as we have calculated in the problem table or graphical approach, and in the design it should also be same. So first you can see number 2 stream is drawn, then number 1 stream is drawn, and now it is from 150 to 50 degrees centigrade and 20 to 200 degrees centigrade. So as you can see, both these streams are drawn over here. Now we have to divide the problem at pinch. Now what is the pinch point? This is the pinch point. Now why it is crossing this line? Because the hot pinch temperature is 150 degrees centigrade. If the hot pinch temperature like could be 120 degrees centigrade, then the pinch point would be here. The hot pinch temperature could be 90 degrees centigrade, then the hot pinch could be here. And similarly, the cold pinch temperature is 130 degrees centigrade. So we have basically divided the problem into two parts. This is above pinch region and this is below pinch region. And as you can see, above pinch, there is only one stream, that is cold stream. Below pinch, there are two streams. One is hot stream and second is cold stream. And these are the pinch temperatures. Let me recall that if this pinch temperature is at, for example, 120 degrees centigrade, then as you can see what it would be. It would be one hot stream above pinch and one cold stream above pinch and hot stream below pinch or cold stream below pinch. Now what it could be? Currently it means it is from 130 degrees centigrade to 200 degrees centigrade above pinch, and below pinch it's 20 degrees centigrade to 130 degrees centigrade, which corresponds to this temperature, and 150 degrees centigrade to 50 degrees centigrade for pitch. But if it would be like 120 degrees centigrade, what it would be? Like for instance, I say that it is 120 degrees centigrade, this point, and this point is 110 degrees centigrade. So what it would be? Above pinch, it would be 150 to 120 degrees centigrade and 110 to 200 degrees centigrade for cold stream. And for hot stream, 150 to 120. And for below pinch, it would be 120 to 50 degrees centigrade and 20 to 110 degrees centigrade. So that's the overall system, and it could vary. Like in current system, there is no stream of hot above pinch. So it means the whole requirement will be met by a utility. And in this case, which is the below pinch, both these streams exchanges heat. And then you will require a cooling utility. Above pinch, you require a heating utility. Below pinch, you require a cooling utility. Now, how to calculate the heat loads over here? The CP value of this stream is 1. The CP value of this stream is 1.8. So as you can see, initial temperature, final temperature, heat load, CP, these values are already given. And load above pinch, how you can calculate it? How you calculated this heat load? 200 minus 20 multiplied by 1. So it was 180. And how you calculated this? 50 minus 150 multiplied by 1.8 minus 180. If you remember our previous lecture. But now you know that above pinch, as you can see, 130 to 200 degrees centigrade is above pinch and 20 to 130 degrees centigrade below pinch. So how this load can be calculated? 200 minus 130. What it will be? 70. 70 multiplied by 1. It is 70. And the remaining value will automatically go to load below pinch. So you can simply subtract it. 180 minus 70 is 110. Or even if you want to calculate what it will be, 130 minus 20, 110, 110 multiplied by 1 is 110. So when you sum both these, it should be equal to total heat load. If this is not coming as 180, then it means you have done some calculation error. Similarly, there is no hot stream above the pinch, so it will be automatically zero, and all the heat load will be going to this point. Now you can say with confidence that for above pinch you require a heating utility which is of 70 kilowatt, and once you add these two, 180 minus 110, it will be minus 70. The minus 70 will be the cooling utility requirement. So below pinch you require 70 kilowatt cooling utility, above pinch you require 70 kilowatt heating utility, which is quite evident from this point as well. Now if you come to this point, first we need to check the rule. The rule was at above pinch was the number of hot stream should be less than equal to number of cold stream. There is no hot stream above pinch. It means the rule is okay. Number of hot stream 0, cold stream 1, satisfied. Then what was the second rule? Cp of H should be less than equal to Cp of cold. No Cp of H, so it means this rule is also satisfied. Place matches. Since there is no stream over here, so you have to simply provide a hot heating utility or hot utility of 70 kilowatt. Quite straightforward task. And now this above pinch has been solved. Now coming back to this point, you have to exchange the heat between these two streams. I had told you in the previous lecture that here you require a cooling utility. So cooling utility is required for this hot stream, not for the cold stream. That this stream will complete its temperature. It will go from 20 to 130 degrees centigrade by gaining heat from this stream. But this stream cannot be go from 150 to 50 degrees centigrade. If I take you back, that it will gain a maximum of 110 kilowatt. But it has a potential to provide 180 kilowatt. So what you need to do, or what it will be? It will be like, as you can see, there will be a heat exchanger between these two. Like two circles are drawn and they are connected by a vertical line that was said in the first slide over here. And this is a calculation over here. MCPDT, if you remember, we had said in the heat exchanger that Q1 is equal to Q2. The heat duty lost by the hot stream is equal to heat duty gained by the cold stream. We know the temperature of these two streams. It is 20, it is 130. We know this 150, but we do not know this temperature because it cannot go to this 50 part. Otherwise, there would be a complete heat exchange. And if you see the previous slide over here, that 110 minus 180 means it can gain a maximum of 110. So for the 70 kilowatt, we require a cooling duty. So what it will be? MCPDT. This MCP is 1, which is total CP. If you remember, CP is calculated by multiplying M multiplied small CP. It will be big CP value or capital CP. DT, 130, which is the outlet temperature minus inlet temperature. 130 minus 20. And that is inlet temperature minus outlet temperature, which is X multiplied by 1.8. So it will be 88.989 degree centigrade, which is the this value. Now, if you subtract 88.89 from 50 and multiply it by 1.8, which is the CP value of this stream, you will get a cooling utility requirement of 70 kilowatt. So you have proved by the heat exchanger network design that you require a heating utility of 70 kilowatt, cooling utility of 70 kilowatt. You haven't violated any rule. You have used hot utility above pinch. You have used cold utility below pinch. You haven't transferred any heat across the pinch point. You have divided the system at pinch point. So that is the overall correct design of your system. So that's how you do the heat exchanger network design for a two stream problem. And in the next lecture, we will go towards the four stream problem, and that will be a much complex design. And here the rules are again the same, that number of hot stream is equal to number of cold stream. The CP of hot is greater than CP of cold. We have seen this point over here as well. So now this is your homework task, and we have already discussed it in lecture number 24 that I had assigned you to calculate values of heating utilities and pinch temperature. So just use the value, draw the same network diagram and submit me, and obviously it will be linked with your one attendance of this week. And this is the common sense network, but we will discuss at this point later, and you can just see the diagram and check what is the mistake in this diagram. You can see this diagram, common sense network, in the book which I have already shown you. We will discuss this common sense network diagram once we do the four stream design in our next lecture. But for the sake of just reading, I have given you this task, and you have to check what is the problem in this point. Just hint that we have violated some rule over here. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much.